How's it going, everybody? Dotodoya here, back with some more Dragon Ball FighterZ. I am super excited to be doing this video today because we are going to be covering some brand new Dragon Ball Super Broly footage. Thanks to Bandai Namco for hosting the stream. Of course, make sure to go check out the host and Bandai Namco and thank them for doing this, because from what I've heard, this is an optional thing that the host decided he was going to do. So of course, big thanks to them for just giving us a little taste of Broly early. Now is also a good time to say that I'm only going to be covering footage from the combo challenge because, one, I think it shows off a little better of what Broly is capable of doing. It also shows off some of his supers and just general strings that you're going to want to attempt day one. If, however, you would like to watch the full 2-hour stream of all things Broly, including some frame data, some other supers, some special stuff like that, definitely head on over to their Twitch page to do that. The link will be down below. So with all that said, let's go ahead and jump into the combo challenges and talk a little bit about what we're seeing, starting off with combo challenge number one being his square auto combo. Now, right away, you're going to see something big here, and that is that Broly's jab is relatively slow. I think it's a 10-frame startup, which is a pretty far cry from some other jabs in the game. Really, this seems to me as a way to limit his pressure. As you'll see later on in the video, this man has a lot of grabs. I'm guessing they were a little bit afraid of what having a fast jab and also some fast command grabs would do to a person on defense, so they just decided to make his jab a little bit slower. Depending on how you like to play your characters though, this could be a good thing. I definitely prefer more throws on a character. I'm just a big fan of when characters have those kind of tools, so I'll definitely take this. Another thing you'll notice is that Broly also has a very cool cinematic shot in his auto combo. Nothing gameplay related there. This kind of impressive to see that they are included stuff like this for an auto. The last thing to note here with the first combo challenge is the Ender Broly uses. This is just going to be his normal standard heavy. And man, does this thing look beastly. It could just be an animation thing, but the hitbox on this looks impressive. I'd definitely be looking out for this move whenever I see a Broly jumping at me. For Broly's second auto combo challenge, there really isn't too much to say that we won't get into more later. So just to break it down very quickly, you see a few of his mediums attack here. You also get his special and then his level one super at the end. Again, we are going to talk about all of these aspects a little later on in the combos, just because they focus on some of those tools a little more there. Third combo challenge gets skipped because it's just a basic Dragon Rush combo. And the fourth combo challenge is just one of his special moves, the Raging Quake, quarter circle forward square. So this is going to be your go-to. And right away, this move kind of impressed me. You can see here, it's just a lunging attack that attacks his opponent. I thought that was going to be it, but later on in the combo challenges, we also can see that Broly can use this move in the air to bring his opponents back down to the ground. Instantly, I was super sold on the move, right? Because this kind of scenario is very strong in Dragon Ball FighterZ. Not only does it let you get your opponent back to the ground along with you, so you can use any sort of assist to go into a Dragon Rush, into a super, you know, basic bread and butter stuff that you see all the time, or you could just continue the combo, stuff like that. A really powerful tool for Broly to have here. The fifth combo challenge is just another level one that Broly has, aka the meteor shower. It looks a little weird here, but from other things I've seen in the stream, it looks like this is more of something you do after a different level one, which unfortunately isn't shown in these combo challenges. But basically, this is like a follow-up to another super. It looks like you can do it on your own. I don't know. It's going to be interesting seeing what people can do with just that. But for now, that's definitely not something we have too much insight on. Now, the sixth combo challenge is where things start getting a little more interesting for Broly. You can see we have his first grab here, quarter circle back square, aka gigantic fury light. Broly just kind of destroys the man Vegeta here and goes into a super, but again, from other stuff in the stream, it does look like you can also super dash after this, and the grab looks really fast. So obviously grabs in Dragon Ball, super big tool in any fighting game, but here especially with such insane pressure game. Like I said before, I'm a big fan of grabs in fighting games, except when they're used on me, and I can definitely see myself getting tossed around by a good Broly player and just losing the game entirely off a few bad defensive reads. Also, it's nice that it combos so easily into a super, because as long as you have that one bar in those close game scenarios, your opponent is always going to be fearing this thing. So really good tool to make up for Broly's slower jab. Moving on to Broly's seventh combo challenge shows off an interesting mechanic that I believe is unique to just Dragon Ball Super Broly himself. And that is that he has a 2M that can be repeated multiple times, up to 4 times exactly. You'll see here with crouching medium attack, he tries to step on his opponent and you can stop anywhere between, you know, 1 and 4. So if you want to go 2 into a grab, that's fine. It'll catch your opponent off guard. 3 into a grab, or just the full 4. Really just another aspect of Broly's game that's really testing you to try and predict when he's going to go for something different. And then, of course, we see his gigantic heave, which is, of course, just the best move in Dragon Ball FighterZ history. Nah, I'm just kidding. It might not be, but you just drag him across the ground into the corner, which is great for a pressure character like Broly, just because the corner makes it so they have limited options in which, of course, the grab game really excels. And again, we see his jumping heavy attack, which still looks amazing as well. Combo challenge number 8 introduces a few more mechanics Broly has, including his command normal headbutt. I don't know if this is actually a command grab or whether or not you can just block this and not get hit by it. But regardless, it looks really cool and it can be comboed into a racer blow, which knocks them up and lets Broly combo them even further. And then we see his other level one gigantic impact, which you can spend an additional bar after a few additional inputs to turn it into a mega blaster just to get that additional damage. It's always nice to have a super in Dragon Ball FighterZ where you can choose to spend another bar to do more damage. It's just better at keeping point characters in situations where you only have one character left, etc., etc. It's just a nice tool to have. All right, now it's time for combo challenge number 9, and definitely make sure you keep up with this one because this is where you're going to see a lot of the strengths of Dragon Ball Super Broly. So we see his standard mediums attack, and then we also see him jump up to continue the combo, and then he hits us with an air throw. This can easily be comboed after as well, so this is actually a dangerous tool in neutral. If your opponent's jumping around too much, just get up there and yank him out of the sky. Hit him with that chest attack. No, but seriously, this is the move that has me the most excited. A fast air throw in FighterZ just sounds super dumb, and I cannot wait to use it. This is also where we get to see him use Raging Quake in the air to bring him back down, hit him with a level 1, or hey, he could have also hit him with a level 3 here, I suppose. So again, Raging Quake, super great move. Air throw, another great move. Combo challenge number 9, definitely the one that shows the most potential. And now moving on to the last combo challenge, this is your traditional just all out. They just want to show you how cool a combo can look with the character. So you're going to see a lot of good stuff here, pretty basic stuff. And then of course, Gigantic Heave hits as an off the ground grab that you can use to continue combos even further. That's amazing. You see here, the AI does a vanish afterwards as well. Catches him out of the air with another throw into the level 3. And as you can see right here, Broly is clearly the best looking character in FighterZ. That's definitely some grappler bias coming out, but he does look amazing. And of course, it is good to mention that after the level 3, the armor does stay off. You get an electric green aura around you, and Broly will continue to do increased damage for the remainder of the game. That pretty much concludes everything I have to say about Broly here. It's a full analysis of his combo guide, but remember, this is only a small glimpse of what Broly will be able to do in the future, so definitely stick around to the channel to see what tech develops over the coming week while we continue to play Broly in ranked and stuff like that and live stream it, all the good stuff. But yeah, dude, definitely stay excited for what the pros are going to find out with this guy. I could definitely see TOD potential here, especially with that move that brings him back to the ground. That is just going to be that's setting up for some good loops, I think. That's some good loops with proper assist. But yeah, that pretty much concludes our bite-sized Broly video for the day. Let me know down below in the comments what you're thinking about Broly so far. Does he look like the character you wanted? If you weren't excited for him, are you now? And just let me know all of those things down below in the comments. It's always so much fun talking Dragon Ball FighterZ with you guys. While you're down there, make sure to leave a like and subscribe to the channel if you like the stuff we do here. And if you want to watch more videos right away, definitely make sure to check out those few videos up on your screen. Other than that, I have been Dotodoya, and I will see you in the next video.